Namaste and welcome to Bhutan e-learning project. I am Karma Dema and I will be presenting a mathematic lesson for Key Stage 3, that is for classes 7 and 8. So here I have three triangles here, triangle A, triangle B and triangle C. Now look at the triangle and you have to classify the triangles by looking at their angles. Triangle A, what triangle is this? Look at the angles. Okay, this is acute triangle. Now triangle B. Look at the biggest angle. What is the biggest angle there? Okay, that is obtuse triangle. And last we have triangle C. Its angle is 90 degrees, so we can say that is right triangle. Now here we have three triangles. Acute triangle, obtuse triangle and right triangle. Of all these three triangles, today we are going to look at right triangle. I have a right triangle here whose side lengths are 4 cm, 3 cm. Now to make a triangle, we have to join these two points by drawing a diagonal line. Now it becomes a triangle here. Now look at the angle there. So what angle is this? This is 90 degree angle. Now the line which is opposite to 90 degree angle, that is the longest line of triangle and that is known as hypotenuse. The hypotenuse of the triangle has special relationship with two other sides. And this relationship is called Pythagorean theorem. The Pythagoras theorem, or it can be said as Pythagorean theorem, which is proved by a famous Greek mathematician called Pythagoras, who lived in 6th century BCE. After learning Pythagorean theorem, we will learn how to apply Pythagorean theorem to solve word problems. By the end of this lesson, each of you should be able to identify the side length of the given triangle and you should be able to apply Pythagorean theorem to see whether that triangle is right triangle or not. And again, you should be able to apply the Pythagorean theory to see the missing side length of the given triangle where the two sides are given. These are the objectives of the lesson today. Children, today we will look into how Pythagorean theorem works. Before going through that, we will look at the meaning of theorem. Do you know what theorem means? Theorem means it is a fact and it is a truth which is proved by so many reasonings. Okay, now we will look at how Pythagorean theorem works. Okay, children, I have a right triangle here and let's draw a square at side A and square at side B. According to Pythagorean theorem, when we add the area of A and area of B, it should be equal to area of C. Now area A is 4 columns by 4 rows, which makes 16 square units, and area of B is 3 rows and 3 columns, that means it is 9 square units. When we add 16 and 9, we get 25, right? Now let's look at area of C. So you can count 5 rows, 5 columns, 5 times 5, we get 25. So see, area of A plus area of B, when we add together, it is equal to area of C. Here, area of A plus area of B equals to area of C. So this is how Pythagorean theorem works. And in short, we can say this is Pythagorean relationship and it is written as A square, that means area of A, plus B square, that means area of B, which is equals to area of C, that is hypotenuse. Or we can write other way around, like C square, that is area of hypotenuse, is equals to area of A plus area of B. So this is what the theorem states. Here, Pythagorean theorem is used to solve multiple of problems step by step. Of all these, today we will look at two cases here. So I have two cases here. Case number one, is to identify a triangle whether that given triangle is right triangle or not. And case number two, we have to find the missing side length of the right triangle when two sides are given. Okay, case number one, example number one, it says a triangle is given here whose side lengths are 5 cm, 12 cm and 13 cm. Now we know 5 cm, 12 cm and 13 cm, all the side lengths are given here and the length of the hypotenuse here is 13 cm. Now we have to see whether this triangle is a right triangle or not by using the Pythagorean theorem. So here I have the solution here. Let's look together. A, let's say A, side A is 12 cm, side B is 5 cm and side C is 13 cm. Now the Pythagorean theorem says or states C square, that is area of hypotenuse, is equals to area of A plus area of B. So area of A is written as A square, area of B is written as B square. What is the side length of C? The side length of C is 13, so we will write 13 square. And side length of A is 12, so we will write 12 square plus side length of B is 5, so we will write as 5 square. When we say 13 square here, you have to multiply 13 times 13. We get 169. Let's try to find out the area of A, that means A square. Written as 12 square. So 12 times 12, that is 144 plus B square is 5 square. So let's say 5 times 5, we get 25. Now you have to add A square and B square. So when we add 144 plus 25, we get 169. And area of C or area of hypotenuse is also 169. Now we got 169 equals to 169. Now what can you see from here? Let's say the left hand side and the right hand side, they are equal. Hence it is proof that this triangle is a right triangle. Now the given side length of the triangle which I explained to you is 5, 12 and 13. When we check this using the Pythagorean theorem, we came to know that the right hand side is equal to left hand side and it is proof that that is the right triangle. That's why this 5, 12 and 13 is called Pythagorean triples. Okay, that is called Pythagorean triples. And I have some more examples of Pythagorean triples here. So example number 1, that is 3, 4, 5. The triangle with these side length, they can be a right triangle. And the second one is 6, 8 and 10. Third one is 7, 24, 25. And the fourth one is 20, 21, 29. And the second last is 8, 15, 17. And the last one is 20, 99 and 101. There are lots of Pythagorean triples. Do you know why are they called Pythagorean triples? Because these are the whole number side length of a right triangle. That's why they are called as Pythagorean triples. So now you know how to apply Pythagorean theory to see whether that given triangle is right triangle or not. And you know few of Pythagorean triples. Now let's move forward with the case number 2, that is finding the missing side length when the two side length of a triangle is given. Example number 2 here, I have two examples. Okay, let's look at first example. I have a triangle here whose sides are given as 15 cm and 8 cm and the hypotenuse is not given here. Now we have to find the hypotenuse using the Pythagorean theorem. Now let's look at the side length of the given triangle here. Side A and side B is given. Side C, you have to find it out. Side A is given as 8 cm. Side B is given as 15 cm. And side C is question mark as we are going to find out. C square equals to A square plus B square. So as C C is not given, we will write it as C square that is equals to A square that is h square plus when we say B square as the side length of B is 15, so we will write 15 square. Okay, now C square will remain the same as we do not know the value. A square that is h square, that means 8 times 8 is 64 plus 15 square, that means it is 15 times 15, which we get 225. Now we got the area of A and area of B, 64 plus 225. When you add 64 plus 225, we get 289. Now C square is equals to 289. Now here we have a situation here. We got the area of C, area of hypotenuse, but here we need to find the side length of C, not square. Okay, so we have to remove square here. To remove square here, we will make a square root. Let's say square root of C square is equals to square root of 289. Okay, why did we make square root here? Because we want to remove C square here. Okay, we have to remove square here, or we can say we have to remove the exponent here. So to that we make it square root. So square root of C square equals to square root of 289. Square root of C square is C, and square root of 289 is 17. Therefore we can say side length of C is equals to 17 centimeter. Means the side length of the hypotenuse is 17 centimeters. See, the Pythagorean theorem is very easy to use if you know or if you remember the theorem. In triangle number 2, one of the hypotenuse, length of the hypotenuse using the Pythagorean theorem. Now in example number 2, hypotenuse and the other side is given and we have to find the other side length. First let's list down the side length of the triangle. Now side length A is not given, so we have to find out, so let's put a question mark there. And side length of B is given as 24 cm. Side length of C, which is the hypotenuse, is given as 26 cm. Pythagorean theorem states it is C square plus A square plus B square. When you add the area of A and area of B, that should be equal to area of C. C, that is the area of hypotenuse. So C as given as 26, we will write it as 26 square, and A is not given, so we will write as A square plus the side length of B is given as 24, so as we are finding the area of B, we will write it as 24 square. Now children, look here and you have to listen carefully, as we are going to find the area of A. So let's rearrange the theorem a bit. We will write A square equals to C square minus B square. Now you may be thinking that why this symbol changed from addition to subtraction. Now listen, I'll explain. When we are bringing, like we took A square to the left side and we brought C square to the right hand side. So when we change the places, okay, the sign changes. So that's why it is minus C square minus B square. Now we can easily find the missing side length. So A square we have to find out, so we will write it as A square, and the side length of C is given, so we will write 26 square minus 24 square. Now when you multiply 26 times 26, we get 676 minus, when we multiply 24 times 24, we get 576. Now we got area of A equals to 676 minus 576. So let's say, let's take away 576 from 676 and we will get 100. Now we got area of A equals to 100. Now what should we do here? Okay, as we we are not finding the area of A, but we are finding the side length of A. So we have to remove square there by putting square root. Square root of A square is equals to square root of 100. So square root of A square is A and square root of 100 is 10. Therefore, side length of A is equals to 10 centimeter. See children, I told you that once you know how the Pythagorean theorem works, it is very easy to find any missing side length. Children, now we have done with all the examples which we required. We discussed about case 1 and case 2. And in case 1, we tried to find whether that given triangle is a right triangle or not. And in case number 2, we tried to find out the missing side length when the two side lengths are given. So it is very interesting, right? The Pythagorean theorem itself is very interesting. Now let's move forward with activity questions here. I have few questions, and the question number 1, the triangles are given there and you have to identify which is the hypotenuse in each triangle. So let's look at first triangle, triangle ABC. Now triangle ABC, by looking at the triangle only, you will know that triangle is a right triangle because it has the biggest angle as 90 degrees. Now from this triangle, you have to identify which side length is the hypotenuse. Can you tell children? Yes? Yes. Line AC is hypotenuse of triangle ABC. Let's look at second question. And here again I have triangle DEF. Now from triangle DEF, which is the hypotenuse of triangle? Yes, it is. EF is hypotenuse of triangle DEF. Why or how do you think that line EF is hypotenuse of the triangle? Because it is the longest side of the triangle and it is opposite to 90 degrees. That's why that line EF is hypotenuse of the triangle. Now I have activity question 2. A triangle is given there and the side lengths are given. You are not asked to find the side length of the given triangle, but you have to see whether this triangle is right triangle or not. Okay? And again, don't worry here, you don't have to do it. We will solve it together. So let's check whether that triangle is right triangle or not. Side A is given as 5 cm. Side B is given as 7 cm. Side C is given as 10 cm. And the Pythagorean theorem states that A square plus B square equals to C square. By now you are very much familiar with this Pythagorean theorem. As the side length of A is 5, so we will write it as 5 square plus 7 square, which is equals to 10 square. Okay? So when we say 5 square, that means you have to multiply 5 times 5. 5 times 5 is 25 plus 7 times 7, that is 49, equals to 10 times 10, that is 100. Now A square we got as 25 centimeter and B square as 49 centimeter, C square as 100 centimeter. When you add A square and B square, you get 74 equals to, and area of C is 100. 74 is not equal to 100. So from this answer only, we know that the given triangle is not a right triangle. It is a triangle, but it is not a right triangle. We are coming to the end of this lesson. I have a question for you to explore. A ladder which is 13 meter long is placed on the ground in such a way that it touches the top of the vertical wall, which is 12 meter high. Now you have to find the distance. Let's say we have a 12 meter high, okay, 12 meter tall wall here, and we have the ground here, and we place a ladder here in a diagonal way, 13 meter. Now you are asked to find the distance from the bottom of the wall to the bottom of the ladder. So here you can use the Pythagorean theorem and you will get your answer very easily. Thank you. Until today, I hope you enjoyed my lesson. Thank you.